Coming on the Zoom.
Okay.
Back off now!
Got it. Is it automatically focusing?
Yeah, it takes a while for it to click in, so sometimes you gotta see it.
Why does it say please set clock?
Restrictive to both me and
really
well, just the sense of it, you know, because we were awed by the process, and I'm not used to thinking that far ahead, mm-hmm. you know. And I mean, I would see prints that were great, and you realize that the guy put on the yellow part like 3 months after he started the thing, mm-hmm. and they would like tell us that with pride and glee how it all tied together. I'd be stunned by that because I'd be thinking, fuck, I can't even think of what I'm going to do tonight, you know.
Well, you're right.
So I tended to, like, even with that one night you helped, I just tended to come back each day and say, let's do this, and then there was a part where I said, let's do it more, you know, but it didn't have I had a clue.
I think they turned out okay.
Oh, I think they did too. I was real happy with it, but it was a great learning experience to do that.
But a lot tighter shop, yeah.
Yeah, it was terrible. And also, you know, when you came in you always felt that in spite of all the glee and the improvisation and all that, it was also a very formal time, you know, because they had other writers there to deal with and
the business.
Brainerd and I would like come in and we'd go out and get drunk and then we'd come back and fiddle around all that kind of stuff. And they tolerated us for maybe that one day, you know. But, you know, we couldn't phone up each other. I got a great idea. Let's go over there tomorrow or something like that. It was interesting to try and do that.
Well, Otis's approach is
it's more fluid, I think.
Well, it's a lot different.
Yeah.
Well, it's more.
They don't take it serious.
Well, it's not. It's more compatible with how I'm thinking it this way. Actually, to be quite honest, I probably think that. If I went back to a more formal studio, with what I've learned with Otis, I'd probably be a lot more comfortable and probably and get results that I...
Very little, but probably enough to do this with.
On top nowadays, we use the baby powder and it's really tighter.
Now this focuses by itself?
Yes, you should always just sort of hold it for a second. Zoom and it'll just lock quite nice.
How does it know what to focus on?
I have no idea. Wait till you we'll play it back.
Do you need some teleports?
No, I got some. This would be really nice. I don't take this part too serious. Tolkien is awesome. Until it's in ink. When it's in the ink stage, then I really let the talk sit for 15 minutes at least so that it absorbs into the ink. Because it doesn't really do much to this.
For the drawing,
no. Anything, it makes it a bit of a problem. You keep rushing it. Smear some
of the grease around. Old girl would do it. Shit his pants.
Those arms of Gerald. Big hairy arms. You seen the tamarind look?
He paints all that on, you know. That's not real.
I confronted him with that yesterday. I told him. I said, oh, your hairy arms in that book. He goes, yeah.
Stand in.
You don't look that big anymore, Gerald. Gerald Artresian. 18 drops.
18?
Is that too low? She went higher. 25?
It's hard to say it is.
She's blessing. She's blessing.
Thank you, Anna. No problem.
Spread it right out. Chintzing on the gum around here, that's what we're doing. You run out of the gum in the country, you gotta go all the way to the studio to get it. They won't give you any unless you bring your own container and things like that. Derek Redmond.
No, he knew what he was doing.
He does movies, apparently. He's down. Write Laurie Anderson and tell her she's in my soundtrack.
Right,
yeah, say hi to your...